Hi, everyone. Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 13.6.1 and iOS 14 Beta 4 have been out for at least a few days or over a week, depending on which one you're running. And so I wanted to talk about the overall experience, any bugs that I'm having and that you're having based off the YouTube community poll, as well as when to expect iOS 14 Beta 5, and also whether or not you should update to iOS 13.6.1 if you haven't already. So if you want to jump to any part of this particular video just to see what's most important to you, check out the time codes below, or you can see it in the little scrubber bar in the video. And so the first thing before I talk about the update is, if you're not familiar with this already, there was some huge news for the gaming world at least, and that has to do with Fortnite. Fortnite was removed from the iOS App Store as well as the Google Play Store on Android, and that's due to them violating the payment setup of both of those app stores. They pushed an update to try to do their own payment system, and that's against the actual policies of both stores. And I think that was a move to try and get some change pushed through as far as the app stores go, but we'll see what happens with that in the future. But let me know if you play that game in the comments below. Now, as far as iOS 13.6.1, I'm running it on my iPhone XS Max that I have here. I haven't shown this in a video in a while, so I thought I'd bring it out. And then also the iPhone 11, as well as the iPad Air 2. So I have it on all of these devices, and so I wanted to talk about how it's been. And so the first thing is, it's been pretty solid. Now, it's not the main version of iOS that I use, but performance-wise, it's been good, and my family is running it, so I have some reference there. So performance has been good. Most people are saying this is the best version of iOS 13, and it really should be at this point. It should be that Apple has fixed everything. And so you'll see things seem fast. There was a little bit of a glitch there. And on the iPhone 11, well, the iPhone 11, we're going to have the same experience. So basically everything that you have in the iPhone XS Max and the iPhone 11 should basically be the same. So I wouldn't really expect any difference as far as performance there, but you'll see performance seems to be good. Scrolling through things is nice and fast. And just in general, most people are saying it's really good as far as that goes. Some are actually saying that Face ID is a little bit faster. So if I have a Face ID phone and I lift it up and swipe up at the same time, you'll see it unlocks nice and fast. I didn't notice any specific difference, but quite a few people are saying that. Also, people are saying that it gets less hot than it did before. Only one person, I think, said that it was getting warm still, but they're saying most of the time the phone doesn't heat up doing tasks that are, whether it's gaming, although expect it to heat up some if you're doing intensive gaming, maybe Call of Duty or one of those, but in general, it seems to be performing really well and being less hot in general. Now, some people are saying that there is an issue with the share sheet showing up, and I've seen this on a few different posts as well as people that have shared this with me, so that if maybe you were going to a website, well, this is a support website about security updates, maybe we'll share here, it would show up blank when you go to share. It just wouldn't show up at all. And so for me, it's working, but there are a few people where it just sort of disappears and we're not sure why. Also, Instagram notifications apparently aren't showing up for some. So if you're looking for some notifications, apparently they're not showing up properly for some people. So just keep that in mind. Maybe you need to look for an update for Instagram, or they need to push an update. But most people are saying it's good. So hopefully it's just something that the app needs to be updated with. Now, on iPad, the same thing is true. Even on such an old device like the iPad Air 2, this is one of the oldest supported iPads. Performance seems good, and you'll see have some different games on there. And maybe if we go into settings and scroll, performance seems decent. Now, it's not as good as when the iPad first came out. For some reason, Apple, when they make changes, it just seems to slow it down sometimes, but they've sped that back up in general compared to iOS 12, for example. So performance should be better than what it was before with iOS 13.5.1 or 13.6, at least according to most people, but the iPad seems to be working okay there. Now, as far as battery on iOS 13.6.1, well, this is where it gets interesting. I took all of the different comments that you had in the YouTube community poll, which I'll go over some of them later, but I took all of that information as well as a few responses on Twitter, and quite a few of you said that battery is much better. There are a few that say it's not, but one person said, I used to get 6 hours of screen on time for almost 75% battery consumption, but today I got 6 hours and 25 minutes of screen on time for just over 50% battery consumption. Huge improvement. Another person said on their iPhone 11 with the iOS 13.6.1 version, Battery is so much better for me. I used to be at 70% by 11 a.m. and off charge at 8 a.m. I'm at 95% after the update and off charge at 7 a.m. And so they're saying at that time of day, that was about 1 p.m. or so, they're having much better battery life. So I'm seeing that quite a bit from quite a few people. And as far as a percentage goes, based on the comments, 74% are saying they have better battery overall. Now, battery health is not affected by updates. You'll see on my 10S Max and my 11, it's at 100%. But that's just because, well, the 10S Max was replaced. If you saw some of my previous videos with that last year, but you'll see both have 100%. So in general, battery is pretty good on this version. And I would expect that to be the case because, well, it's one of the final versions of iOS 13. So really, I wouldn't expect any different. Now let's take a look at iOS 14 and talk about some of the issues we're having there. Now, as far as iOS 14 Beta 4, I've been using it on my iPhone 11 Pro Max every single day since it came out to developers, and I've also been using it on my iPad Pro 12.9 from 2020. And so this particular update seems to be okay. It still has some bugs, but one thing I have seen is issues with the clock widget. Now, I know some others are not seeing this. In fact, right before this video, it was showing the wrong time. It was showing about 3:45 in the afternoon, and it's actually 4:29 at this particular point. And so I actually had to change where the clock was located. I changed it from Charlotte to New York and changed it back, and then it updated properly. So I'm not sure what's going on there. I know some people had no issues with it, but I see issues with it from time to time. Also, I've had a few issues with messages, although not on the iPhone, mostly in going back and forth between an iPhone and a Mac. So I'm running macOS Big Sur and also macOS Catalina, and I still have the issue on either one. Sometimes the conversation doesn't show up properly. It shows up okay on the iPhone, but on the Mac side, it doesn't. So I'm not sure if that's an issue with the iPhone or if it's an issue with the Mac, but there is that bug there. And then the other issue I had is when I was changing this widget, editing it, yesterday, I believe, the keyboard disappeared. So I'd go in here to type a city and the keyboard all of a sudden just disappeared and I'd have no way to input text. So I actually had to close the app and go back in it a couple times and then it worked properly. So I'm not sure why it keeps doing that, but in general, it has some issues still. The widgets are not able to be interacted with, and I know that's quite a concern for quite a few people, but it's just what they've done for now. So right now they're not updating properly. Hopefully we'll see that fixed with beta 5. Now, as far as other bugs I'm having is some lag and locking up still, and you're saying the same thing. So as far as the overall performance, most of the time, at least on the 11 Pro Max, it's fine. But once in a while, I'll go to input text, or I'll go to open an app, or maybe I'll be in Twitter and it will just freeze. Or maybe I'll be in Telegram and it will just freeze up. I'll have to close the app out and then go back in and I'm good to go. So I'm not sure why this is happening, but again, it's a beta. And with beta 4, well, hopefully we would have had most of this fixed, but I think it's coming along nicely. Some people are saying that Instagram is crashing. Now, the only time I had Instagram crash is actually when I went into follow someone or unfollow someone. That seems to crash it. Everything else seems to work okay for me. So if I go to my Instagram here, you can see if I scroll down through, it's okay. And it's working fine. I can go over here and go to my different Instagram posts and they seem to work okay. Sometimes though, like I said, if you follow or unfollow someone, it will crash. And of course that can be a big problem for most people since that's what you're probably doing quite a few times or even commenting, but I haven't had any issues with that. Now, other than that, some people are saying they're having issues with the camera. I haven't seen any weird bugs with the camera. I haven't had any problems with it whatsoever. It seems to be okay, but for some people it's a problem. So I'm not sure if that's hardware specific or that's specific to the iPhone 7 or 7 Plus, for example, versus the 11 Pro Max, but I'm not seeing that on any devices. When it comes to the iPad, it's been pretty good. In general, I don't have too many issues with the iPad. Occasionally, I have some weird text issues where I can't use things like notes properly, but in general, it's fairly responsive, and it should be for its speed. But battery life on the iPad side has not been great. We'll take a look at battery on the iPhone in just a moment. But battery life on the iPad, at least for me, has not been phenomenal. It's been okay, but I don't charge it every day either. So you'll see here, I went through the battery, and I charged it last night, so I'm probably getting about 7 hours of screen on time where I should be getting about 10. And that seems to be consistent across the iPhone as well. So if we take a look at the iPhone 11 Pro Max and its battery life, we'll go into battery here. and then go to battery health. You'll see I'm at 96%. That's normal after the time I've owned it. And then we'll go to the last 10 days. Updates do not reduce your battery. I know I get this question a lot and I say it a lot, but the updates don't reduce your battery health. They simply remeasure it. And so I had quite a bit of usage here the other day, and you'll see the usage wasn't great. I used almost 100% of my battery and only got 4 hours and 23 minutes of screen on time, 3 hours and 35 minutes of screen off time. If we take a look at yesterday, I got 5 hours of screen on time and it was charging a bit in my car. So it really depends on the day, how you're using it, but probably about 7 or 8 hours of screen on time is normal for me on the 11 Pro Max. Normally I would get 10 to 12. So they definitely can improve it, and I would expect them to improve it in the future. Now, before I talk about the overall statistics of issues that you've mentioned and devices you're using, I want to talk about iOS 14 Beta 5. Quite a few of you are wondering when it will come out, and currently, at least up to this point, and based on what we've seen in the past, we've had a release every 2 weeks up to this point. And so I would expect a release of iOS 14 Beta 5 probably on Tuesday or Wednesday at the latest. Of course, Apple can always change this, and they do from time to time. But based on what we've seen with iOS 12 and 13, that's when I would expect it. Now, after iOS 14 Beta 5, I would expect a weekly release with Beta 6, 7, 8, GM, for example. So we'll probably see iOS 14 GM sometime in late September, with a final release of it to the public probably in October, since Apple's delaying the iPhone 12 at least a few weeks for its launch date. And that's according to Apple. So I would expect them to release iOS somewhere along the release timeframe of iPhone 12. Now, as far as all the issues you've mentioned, here's all the issues you mentioned in the comments from the YouTube community poll, and here's all the devices you were using as well. So if you mentioned a device, I captured it here, regardless of the version you were using. Now let's take a look at the community poll. Now, at the time of recording this video, 6.6K have voted, or 6,600 people have voted. So I really appreciate that. And you'll see there's 229 comments at this point, and I've read every single one up until I started making this video and after I did all those statistics. So you can see here that 47% of you said that it was great. 4% of you said it was terrible. Now, this is referring only to iOS 13.6.1. So 47 said it was great. 4% said terrible. 7% said okay, but some bugs. And 23% of you said you were on iOS 13.6 or older, either not updating or maybe you're on an older iPhone. 18% of you are on Android. And I keep seeing people asking me more about Android and maybe switching, so I'm curious about that. Now, I did run a separate poll on iOS 14 Beta 4 last week, and you'll see there's 22,000 votes and 707 comments. So if you want to see bugs that people are having, feel free to look through this on the community page. There's a lot of good information there, but let's take a look at some of the comments. Now, I apologize if I say your names incorrectly, but I like to give you a little shout out when I can. So Muhammad Ali Siddiqui said, after updating my 11 Pro Max to 13.6.1, my share sheet menu from Photos, Safari, and other apps are blank. Mohsin said, hey Aaron, the green tint on the screen is actually starting to show after the upgrade, which meant to fix it. Strange. So they should have fixed that. Maybe try a reboot and hopefully it's fixed. Daniel Wainwright said, working really well on the 11 Pro. Everything is so good. Best iOS version in such a long time. Jetton Ismail said, iPhone 11 user here. For some reason, battery life on iOS 13.6 gradually deteriorated for me to the point where I was barely getting 7.5 hours of screen on time. Thankfully, 13.6.1 fixed that, back to the usual 8 to 9 hours of screen on time. Shardul Bandu says, using iPhone 10, standby battery drain has been fixed as well. Screen on time has increased drastically. No heating issues now. Keep up the good work. Thank you. Shivam Krishan Agrawal says, every build looks good in the start. I don't know how the battery performance becomes mediocre after some weeks. And it may become mediocre depending on what you install and what goes on. But in general, hopefully most people are saying it's great. And sorry if I mispronounced your name. Abhishek Lamba says, iPhone 11 Pro Max, it's great right now. No bugs, no heating, and the battery life is fine, getting around 11 hours. Jonathan Torres says, currently running 13.6.1 on my iPhone 7, waiting for beta 5 of iOS 14 to join. Thomas35Cost says, iOS 13.6.1 is great for me on my iPhone 11 Pro, but I still have a weird bug that it causes random, really loud sounds when I lock the screen. But overall, everything seems pretty stable. Ethan Kispert says, update has been great so far on my iPhone 10. Battery life seems to have improved a bit. Great update overall. Shravan Kumar says, iPad mini 5, battery life improved a lot. Great little update. Carlos Lopez says, iPhone 8, very smooth. Great, better than previous versions. Calvin H. said that he's running iOS 13.6.1 on an iPhone 8 Plus. The battery health is excellent. It's at 94%. Generally great. Apps open and close smoothly, no stuttering, and browsing seems even smoother than previous versions of iOS. As I was reading through the comments, I saw this one, so I thought I'd answer it. Siva Madhav Chinta says, when will Apple release Apple Silicon MacBooks, and would it have Face ID, and what price would it be? I would expect it to be around the same price, around $1,000 to start, as a MacBook Air, for example. And Face ID, it's hard to say. I really hope so, but there's no information about that at this point. So I'm really hoping that it will be in there, but at this point, it's all just rumors. Venki4791 said, iPhone 6S and iPad 7 user here. iOS 13.6.1 is great. No issues. Battery life holds up better than iOS 13.6. Love from India. We'll take a look at a couple more. Jeremy Gensky says, iPhone 11, everything's running great so far, snappy, smooth, and getting about 10 hours of screen on time. Downgraded back from iOS 14 beta. Your video helped me with that too. Keep up the great content. Thank you, and glad I could help. Devin Boyd said, I keep having issues in messages. When I get a text and open in the screen is black, I have to force close for it to work properly. And also with Apple Music, when I play a song, it will not play. I have to soft reset my phone for it to work. Just waiting for iOS 14 at this point. Mitsos HT says, iPhone 11 Pro Max, battery life is awesome. No bugs or anything weird. Also, the green tint bug is finally fixed for my device. That's it for iOS 13.6.1 and iOS 14 Beta 4. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 13.6.1, well, I would say based on the feedback I've seen so far, absolutely. It seems to be stable. It seems like it's not having issues other than the couple small things that I mentioned. And the people that were having issues with share sheets also seem to be having the issues with the share sheets in previous versions. So it's pretty safe to update at this point and install it on your main device. Now, when it comes to iOS 14 Beta 4, expect iOS 14 Beta 5 along with iPadOS 14 Beta 5, watchOS 7, Beta 5 and macOS Big Sur Beta 5 in this coming week. So expect that pretty soon. I would imagine we'll see that Tuesday or Wednesday, like I said earlier on. Now, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it like I always do in the description below. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.